welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Minnesota Twins. First pitch coming your way next. Just about ready to go, and towing the slab, Pablo Lopez. What do you have on him, Siggy?
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
Gleyber Torres in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Next one misses. Two balls, no strikes. There's a strike. The 2-1. And that's in for a strike. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And now it's filled up. And that's ball four.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
Here comes Aaron Judge. First pitch just misses. At the belt and fires. And now it's even up.
One.
And a pitch.
Nope, that's outside. Ball.
In the air, out towards left center. Makes the grab on the run. And there's one down. Oh, the throw is wild. Here's a look at Aaron Boone's lineup for the Yankees. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience, singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
Left-hand batter waits. That one drifts inside. Good eye right there. The pitch. And misses inside.
Well, on this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Boo.
Two gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And there's ball four.
Almost a coin flip for the umpire in that call, but most umpires just don't want to give pitchers a break up in the zone like that.
Here's Stanton now. Got to be careful with a slugger like this because he could turn it into a three-run game in the blink of an eye. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. And now the 0-1. Minnesota's bullpen with some action. Jorge Alcala up and throwing. Thielbar, a lefty, warming up as well. And a 1-1. Ground ball to first. Could be two. Kirilov over to second. Return throw to first. Got him. Double play. And that'll do it. So they're able to work around a pair of walks in the inning. The Twins coming up. No score. Welcome back. Showing the slab in today's game. Gerrit Cole, what do you have on him?
Power pitcher. He's going to speed you up with the fastball velocity, and out of his hand will explode the breaking ball. Very difficult for hitters to keep that front side closed and hit the ball the other way because they know if they're not ready to pull the trigger, the fastball will beat them.
Now it's the power speed combo. Byron Buxton. The wide to kick the pitch. When Cole's brother-in-law, Brandon Crawford, took him deep, Cole signed a pair of spikes for Brandon Crawford. One that said, adios, pelota, and the other one that said, out of here.
Yeah, calls by the great John Miller and Dwayne Kuiper of the San Francisco Giants.
Next offering upstairs.
He really committed to that fastball up at the top of the zone. He knows that if he makes a mistake in the zone, it gets hit hard by a power guy like this. That's a nice miss right there.
Righty to the plate. Cuts on it, misses. That's a strikeout. Blew the express right by his bat for strike three.
Tell you what, those are the types of guys pitchers really like to punch out when they're on the mound because if they get on, just the distraction that they create with all that speed over on the base pass, it can take away your focus from the next hitter, and that's the last thing you want to do is serve up a pitch that a guy hits over the fence, and it's a multi-run home run.
Carlos Correa in the box now. No balls and a strike. A guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field.
I love that Gerrit Cole is sort of a throwback guy out there on the mound, sort of that classic power pitcher. He's going to attack with that fastball, move it all around the edges of the zone, and when he has to, fill up the strike zone with confidence that hitters can't touch it.
One down, base is empty. Out to center. Bader pulls it down, and there's two away. And now we take a peek at the Twins lineup. Now batting Max Kepler. The outfield shifted pretty heavily towards right field. In there for strike one. Cole, of course, the first overall pick by the Pirates in the 2011 draft out of UCLA, and really blossomed as he moved from Pittsburgh to Houston in 2018. Line drive, and that's a base hit out of the center field.
Batting four. The second base.
So two down, the batter now, Jorge Polanco. And first offering is fouled off.
He's one of the two pitchers to strike out 14 batters in three consecutive games. Pedro Martinez was the other to do it, but Gerrit Cole, again, just a dominant pitcher that wants to finish what he starts.
Kepler off of first with two away. Next offering in the dirt. Now two balls and a strike. Good eye right there. And down on strikes. Third out. One left for Minnesota. We played an inning. No score. Jorge Alcala gets handed the rock out of the pen.
Now pitching for the win. Number 66.
Here's Josh Donaldson. Infield playing him to pull. Second baseman just to the right of the bag. The wind of the pitch. There's the strike.
First pitch strike right there for him. He's going to have to do that consistently if he's going to give any length to his skipper.
Next one is off the play. One ball, one strike. Foul ball there. And the right-hander deals. Got it swinging. It's a strikeout. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three. And now Bader up to the plate. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
Second inning here, no score. The 1-1. And a good eye there.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Swing and a miss. 2-2 now. Next offering misses down and away. The wind and the pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Now here's Aaron Hicks. Alcala with a move to first. Bader dives back. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. One miss. A plate umpire, Freddie Ferguson. Oh, and he hit him.
Now the pressure was already high, and now it's been cranked up to another level. Man, his head must be spinning out there on the mound. He's got to find a way to slow things down. That breathing technique, Boog. Let everything out.
Oswald Peraza in the box now as he leaves that one up high. Even up.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
In the dirt, but kept close. Runners stay put, and the count moves to 2-1. that one in for a strike, 2-2.
Man, 91 on the slider right there. That's a hard one. That's a low-end fastball for some guys.
Next offering upstairs. Got him looking. Two gone.
Well, you got to be ready to swing the bat with a runner in scoring position and two strikes. Just put the ball in play somewhere, and you've got a chance. Very frustrating for him, I'm sure. See if the next guy can pick him up.
Here's Jose Trevino. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Bader over at second. Hicks on at first with two down. Foul ball. Here's a 1-1. Base hit center field. Here comes the runner. Here's the throw to the plate. It's offline, and he scores. And it's 1-0.
Always feels good when you come through and get your team on the board first. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field. Now a huge at-bat in this game coming up.
Here's Gleyber Torres. He reached out a walk his first time. Swings through that one. 0-1. First and second, two down. On the ground to the left, Miranda handles. They take the force out. That ends the inning. And they limit the damage. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's an early 1-0 lead. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. We head to the bottom of the second. Now the third baseman, Jose Miranda. Yeah, the right-hander back to work. And there's a ball. Upstairs. Two up. In the air, left field. Hicks is there for it. Makes the catch for the out.
Batting fifth. No left field.
And now it's Joey Gallo.
Gallo.
First offering misses badly for ball one. Looking to get the tying run on base. Swing and a miss. Chased it out of the zone.
Guy out there sees a power hitter take that kind of swing. He's got to be thinking, is this guy trying to set me up? Now let's see if he can make an adjustment.
Next pitch just misses. And that's ball three.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Well, when you commit to throwing an inside fastball to your glove side across the strike zone, especially with two strikes, if you're going to miss, you want to miss off the plate in. You do not want to leave it out over the heart of the plate. So that was excellent execution on that pitch. Really tied him up, and he couldn't get a piece of it.
Here's Alex Kirilloff. And fouled off. The 0-1. Kirilloff tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. And he went around. That's ruled a swing. The line of the pitch. Down and in. Moved his feet. Swing and a miss. And that is that. Twins are set down 1-2-3. And it remains 1-0. Pitcher on here, Dennis Santana. And this guy can bring it velocity wise. Get it. Yeah, the hard throwing righty trying to secure these outs against a potent Yankee lineup, but it starts with Aaron Judge. And here it comes. There's a strike. Santana, 26 years old. They got him off of waivers earlier this season. Comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now. And a ground ball to first. A flip to the pitcher covering. Leadoff hitter gone in the third.
Good arm side run to that same side hitter right there. Very difficult to put that ball in the air or get through it. Just bores in on the hands.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. The outfield shifted pretty heavily towards right field. And first offering is fouled off. Started to swing, held up.
Almost got him to commit, but he held back.
Swing and a miss. Gonna count 1-2.
Filthy changeup right there. Just pulled the string.
Out there, and there's two down.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed, it's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. They tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
And now it's Giancarlo Stanton. He hit into a double play his first time up. That one's in there, 0-1. Now 1-1. On the ground. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. Safe. Fantastic effort, but that extends the inning.
He was all over that one. Pitch was in and off the plate. So hard to do anything with the pitch in that location, but somehow he got the barrel to it and hit it well. Pretty amazing.
Now it's Josh Donaldson's turn to hit. Went down on strikes his first time through. Next pitch downstairs. Ball one. And he deals.
Ball outside.
That one missed. Now 3-0. Stanton off of first with two away. There's a strike, 3-1.
Clearly taking all the way there in that 3-0 count. It was a cookie right down the middle.
So now two on and two outs.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner in the scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
And up next for New York, Harrison Bader. He walked and came around to score his first time up. In there, and it's 0-1.
There was a high-velocity fastball in the zone. I think a little frustration from walking the previous hitter. He's got good stuff. Pitch inside the zone and trust it.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
Got him. Out number three. So they strand a pair. We head down to the home half of inning number three. Yankees 1 and the Twins nothing. Clay Holmes on a pitch out of the pen here.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Here's Christian Vasquez.
And things could change quickly here with one swing.
The pitch. Right through there for a strike. And a pitch. He swings and fouls one off.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit. Just not able to square it up.
Kicks and deals. And takes low for ball one. Pitch stays alive. Right-handed reliever, and another ball. Here comes a pinch. Called out on strikes. Fastball at the letters, frozen for strike three.
No, just excellent location on that inside fastball. Really locked him up. And as a hitter, it's not typically what you're looking for. You're trying to protect away and then in. So you can be a little bit tardy with two strikes. Hard to tell if he was fooled or if he thought it would be called a ball. But either way, that's a really nice pitch.
So up next for Minnesota, Nick Gordon. He's someone that really beats up on right-handed pitching. The lefties, however, give him a little bit more trouble. First offering misses the mark. A one-run lead, and the home team trying to pull it out. Popped up, Peraza on the move. Got it. Covered plenty of distance there. Out number two. Buxton. Back to the leadoff spot in the Twins lineup. And now the center fielder, Byron Buxton. This guy with light tower power.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Fly ball, that one out towards left center field, way back there. He's got it. Ball game. The Yankees claim the win here behind some great pitching and defense.
So much rides on each and every at bat in these three-inning games. It's like the playoffs. Sometimes all it takes is one big swing and some great pitching to come away with a quick 1-0 win.
The final 1-0 for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
Our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Yankees. One run on two hits. No errors. They left six men on base. For the Twins, no run.